Good morning, my dear students. Welcome to MagnusIAS with our tagline, learn at your own pace. Your own pace, anytime, any place. I am starting the views on news series of today's newspaper. Today is 15th September 2017. And this is the news analysis from the today's newspaper, The Hindu. We know very well that in the civil services, the news analysis is the most important aspect, and most of the time, even for the static portion, whatever the questions are being asked, they are having their bearing on the newspaper analysis itself. My point is that in normal way also, a normally prudent student is in a position to answer 40 questions. And with this news analysis, I am adding some at least minimum 32 questions, that is our analysis, then he is in a better position to qualify for the examination. So with that aspect, MagnusIAS has introduced this one. Earlier it was available in the tablet PC, now it is available on the YouTube for you. In the today news, some of the salient points are there, and these salient points require to be deliberated, like I am just showing you some of the salient points that from the today newspaper. The Indo-Japan friendship treaty, whatever is going on, the bullet train and all those things, in that you might just miss this point. The point is the South China Sea. This is very important from the civil services perspective, because in the South China Sea, we find that there are so many countries like the China, that is the People's Republic of China, or Republic of China, that is the Taiwan. Taiwan is there, then Vietnam, the Brunei, the Philippines, they all, Malaysia, they all are claiming their rights. It is the most conflicting zone in the world. And now Japan and India, these two have thought that yes, for the Afro Asian Growth Corridor, that is also important. Growth corridor, this South China Sea, and for this they are talking that yes, we want that there should be free access. You just see, almost $3 trillion trade is going on through this route. So you just see how much important is this place, and this is very important. They may ask you that Paracel Islands, or they may ask that Malacca Strait. In that way, they can ask that whether do you know the real map work of this place or not, or a strategic importance. So, my dear sir, it is very important. So, in that aspect, in the editorial page, there is a Ranthambore. Regarding the Ranthambore, I am just showing you the Ranthambore related to the national park they have asked. And this one is important, that Ranthambore National Park, they may ask that at which place it is. Ranthambore, it is near to Sawai Madhepur. And you have to understand, so in that article, certain aspects will be coming related to the Ken Betwa, for that the author is talking. The author is talking about the gene isolation. She is talking about genetic isolation, then speciation, all these aspects. These aspects are related to science and technology. The location is related to this one, I mean ecology and environment and geography, and certain aspects related to the ecology and environment also. Last year also we have got one question. So this is the approach, that you have to understand the news from there the questions are actually coming. Now we'll ask that why I have chosen Hindu. First thing is that most of this students are choosing Hindu, they are having certain logic for it, and I also do, because I am finding that most of the things are covered in Hindu in a multidimensional approach, and civil services focuses on the multidimensional approach only. This news as such not so important, I will not deal with this one, yes, but this North Korea Japan drudge in India. Here you just see, at some point they have asked that they have told that a joint statement issued after the summit sought the implementation of the resolution 1267 of UN Security Council to counter cross-border terrorism. So cross-border terrorism, that is one important aspect. The second is the North Korea And North Korea and its the threat they are having from the North Korean's nuclear and missile programs. This is one important aspect. The third important point about which I was telling that both sides stood for freedom of navigation in the South China Sea. Normally, in the course of a study, we miss this point, South China Sea and its importance, but it is very important from my point of view. Besides this thing, they are trying to give some measures for the significant move. Japan has stated its interest in the strategic important northeastern regions of the country. Japan at present has two infrastructure projects in Meghalaya and Mizoram, and more projects are likely to come. So from that aspect, this is also important. So we are finding that this one, the South China Sea, and they are having the maritime self-defense force, and there is some joint statement are there, greater maritime domain awareness, all these aspects. So related to the South China Sea, it is very important aspect. A study we have discussed in context of Japan related to the haplobank, blastocyst and stem cells. So these aspects are related to science and technology, but because Japan, Japan the friendship is going on, so this is becoming important, not only the bullet train. You have to, correct some of the data related to the bullet train. I have given you the data of 1 lakh crore and 535 kilometer. Now, in today newspaper, I am finding that, no, it is 508 and 1,10,000 crore. So, this is not so important from the UPSC point of view. The minor variations are there, but yes, you should have a real idea. It is always better. The editorial of today is of little bit significance for us because it is related to the GST regime, and they have told that though just 75 days has passed and almost 3 months waiting period was there, now 70% eligible could only pay the tax, but we have got 95,000 crore, which is though we had expected only not more than 91,000 crore, but if the speed will be going like that, we will get 1,20,000 crore, like 1.2 lakh crore. Okay, so this is the aspect they are telling, but there is one problem they are telling, that there are certain technical glitch in the sense that there are not net connectivity, that's why the date is being enhanced. So from that aspect, to just go through it, make two or three points, and these are not that important. Regarding the German Chancellor, that is the Angela Merkel re-election, the German Chancellor seems all but certain. Angela Merkel, dynamic personality, she will become the German Chancellor, but it is not having direct bearing with India, so it is not important. Most important news from the today newspaper, I am finding that creating corridors of certainty. Here, the author, this is Neha Sinha, she is a conservationist, she is of the environmental conservation spokesperson like that. She is talking about Ranthambore. My dear sir, you will may be asked that what is the location of the Ranthambore. I have shown you the chart, shown you the drawing, that it is shown you the map, that it is near to the Sawai Madhopur. What is the location of the Sawai Madhopur? How much it is far from Ajmer? How much it is far from Delhi? How much from Gwalior? That please draw a hand-drawn map. I am always telling you, if you are drawing a hand-drawn map, you will at least get 4 questions correct in your examination. I am very much sure. I will tell you. Just in the Tiger Corridor, I am giving you I will give you some of the questions, and you will see that how you will be able to answer those questions based on that only. Here the key aspects of this one is there. The author is telling about the Tiger Corridor. She is talking about the genetic diversity and isolation, this aspect. She is telling about that India is having more than 60% of the global tiger population, please note it down. She is asking for the ecological balance, the territorial behavior of the tiger, that they roam around in a big territory. Ken Betwa River interlinking project. And Mukundra Tiger Reserve of Ranthambore, that is the spillover tigers, okay? So these aspects, these are the important aspects. Now let us try to understand this important aspects which I have told. What does it mean by genetic diversity and genetic isolation? You see that, suppose this is an area and here the tigers are there, okay? Suppose there are 60 tigers, as the author is telling that 60 tigers are there in this area, that there will be breeding in breeding between the 60 tigers only. Means gene of one tiger matching with this one, and in this way, gradually what happens when crossings are there, so the weak genes which are not normally manifested sometimes, they get manifested and if time comes that as a result of such isolation due to inbreeding, the species becomes weaker and weaker, immunity becomes less, the physical features are retrogressive type, less. So isolation is not good. That's why in a family there is no marriage system, no? That is also one of the biological reasons. When there is a diversity is there, suppose some more tigers are brought in here, let me draw with some other color, and suppose some more tigers are brought here, yes, some more tigers are brought, then there will be not such type of the inbreeding isolation behavior, and as a result there will be healthy tiger. At present healthy tigers are brought, but when they are brought to the new environment, there are certain other problems. So they are telling that tigers, as in by nature, are having the territorial behavior. Their territories are vast expanse. Like the tiger from Ranthambore, they will go even up to Pilibhit in UP. They will roam around up to the Gwalior near Panna. Then they will come to this place, I mean Ranthambore. And you just see for the vast expanse. They will go from the Bharatpur, they will cross, go to Pilibhit, they will come up to the Panna, and they are roaming around, and then outbreeding, not inbreeding, outbreeding are there, and as a result, there will be healthy genes in that. So the author is telling that there should be a tiger corridor. Like that, I'm just telling about the tiger corridor. It's good that we are having maximum number of the tiger population, it's good. But the thing which are going on, that at present development versus the tiger conservation. So this one point is also important, National Tiger Conservation Authority, please do make a write-up on this one, National Tiger Conservation Authority. Then they are talking about the Ken Betwa River Interlinking Project. Ken Betwa River Interlinking Project as such also very important. Draw a map, freehand map of the Ken River and Betwa River, okay? Betwa River means Jhansi Orcha, okay? Orcha ke Ramji, that's all, you just recall it. Jhansi Ram Orcha, the Betwa, and here all the Octopussy movie, etc. has been shooting has been done at Orcha only. It is a very good 5-star resort there at that place. So this goes up to Hamirpur and Yamuna River. Okay, Ken River, it goes through the Panna National Park. Now you just see that this one is going, this one. Okay, this Ken Betwa proposed what? What will happen, some of the area of the Panna National Park, etc., there will be encroachment, the tiger's reserve, Panna is a tiger reserve, no? So this problem is there. So the Ken, this type of the developmental projects are jeopardizing the tiger's territorial behavior. Now let us see, I was just telling you one thing, that how could you answer the questions related to the tiger reserve once you have done the freehand drawing of the map. You just see, I am showing you the question. This question was asked last year. So from the ecological point of view, which one of the following assumes importance of being a good link between the Eastern Ghat and Western Ghats? They do ask this type of the questions, that which mountain is having the link between the Eastern Ghat and Western Ghat. Normally they do ask that type of the question also. Now they are asking for the tiger reserves, because you just see Western Ghats, that thing, Silent Valley projects, the biospherical reserves, and these all things are very important. Always one question will be asked everywhere from that aspect. That should be clear to you, because it is very ecologically sensitive zone. If you have drawn the map of the tiger reserves freehand, then you could have seen that which one is near the Kerala, which one is the Karnataka, and which one is at the Tamil Nadu. And this area, mainly they are asking the questions from this area only. Means which tiger reserves are in which state. If you are having that idea, then the tiger reserve which are there in the Tamil Nadu here, this will be the Western Ghat and Eastern Ghats boundary, okay? This place. So let us see. You just see, this is the map. You just I have drawn like the Corbett just on the boundary of this one Uttar Pradesh, the Valmiki, the boundary of the Bihar and this one Pilibhit, like that I have drawn, although I have not drawn, it is taken from the Wikipedia, okay, Google in fact. The Sarishka is there, Sarishka is at this place, okay, and Ranthambore and Mukundara, the name had come in that article itself, that whatever the spillover tigers are there, they are being sent to Mukundara. So in Rajasthan you are having the three tiger reserves, you know these are all on almost near the boundary, okay. In Madhya Pradesh you just see very interesting that this Pech, Satpura, Melghat, means you just see this place, if you are coming somewhere near to this place, this is the tiger capital. It is Nagpur. In and around you are finding a lot of tiger reserves. Taroba, Bor, Pech, Kanha, Bandhavgarh, they all you can go from Nagpur. Not very far, and then Jabalpur also, but Nagpur is considered. You just see the here Sahyadri, okay? Now you come here, you are finding the Nagarhol, Bandipur, and this one is Satyamangalam. And what was the question? Satyamangalam. Satyamangalam is at the border of the Tamil Nadu. So this one is the connecting link. Other are Annamalai and all those are on the other side, I mean on the towards the eastern ghats. So just see, what is the question? That this one is the correct answer. Nallamala, Nagarhol, etc., they are on the other side. So this type of the drawing of the map, so you, what you have to do, that state wise which tiger reserves are there. Tamil Nadu, these four tiger reserves. Then Karnataka, these five, and Kerala, these two. If you are making it in that way, it will be very easy for you to follow it. Regarding Rohingya, you have written a lot. I know that you all are very expert, mastery over the Rohingya, and you can speak for 1 hour on Rohingya problem only. Some aspects you can just understand. The principle of refoulement, this one you little bit you should understand. Principle of refoulement. This is the United Nations Convention of 1951, Section 33, somewhere it is written, Article 33. This aspect should be, I mean, known to you, Article 53. And this one, principle of non-refoulement. This aspect, 1951, Article 14 and Article 21, somewhere it is written. With that perspective, 14 and 21 of this one, if you understand this one, then it is very good. You understand the basic aspects. The same Rohingya problem has been dealt here also. In this Rohingya problem, they are understanding from three perspectives. Maintaining traditional generosity, Buddha, Atithi, Devo Bhava, etc. What we have done with Tibet. Economic. When economic will be there, Kaladan, Sitwe project. That is important. Kaladan, multimodal transit transport project. That you have to link. India's Act East policy, means we should have good friendship with the Bangladesh also. Then the Rakhine province extremist violence is there. Anyhow, and now they are telling that what to do, that Kofi Annan is already doing some work there. Let us wait for it. We should have good relations with Burma also, Myanmar also. Otherwise, China will have their influence there. Moreover, we can give some economic package to Bangladesh for giving them certain solace, certain assistance for the Rohingya problem. That these has been discussed. So this is not that way very important. The new highways is also important because it is talking about national waterways. So we know very well that what the problem NHAI, National Highway Authority, is getting. From that perspective, the author is analyzing that acquisition of land for national and state highway becomes scarce and cost of construction of roads, flyover, bridges goes up. The government is now exploring using water as a means of public transport. Water, the National Waterways, okay? With the enactment of the National Waterways Act 2016, the total number of national waterways is now 111. So this is important. How many national waterways are there? Which one is the Act 2016? Questions may be expected because this is a burning problem and this is important also. But providing infrastructure such as you have to provide jetties, terminals, navigation channels, and boats, ships, and all those things, this is really a problem. The government has proposed an amendment to the Central Road Fund Act. Central Road Fund Act is what? That Central Road Fund Act, this bill implants National Waterways into 2000 Act. Okay. The bill proposes using part of the cess collected on high-speed diesel, whatever the high-speed diesels are there or petrol are there, means up to 2.5% of the cess of the high-speed diesel petrol is being provided, then 2.5% here it is written, then almost rupees 2000 crore per annum will be expected to be given to this National Waterways. So the Ministry of Road Transport and Highway, which tabled the bill in Lok Sabha, said National Waterways provide a cost effective and all those things. It is really environmental friendly also, cost effective also. So for the funding, this 2.5% of the cess on high speed diesel and petrol, this will give rise to 2000 per crore per annum. So these are the important aspects. So based on that, you can write a small write up that what are the, in which way the funding can be done to the National Waterways. So this is one important aspect. So we have seen that today the Tiger Corridor, gene speciation, isolations, these things, Rohingya problem, certain aspects, not only three or four lines only, that will be important for you. Then we are finding that Japan we have understood, and there is no such great, yes, something related to this one, I was just telling that this is 1.1 lakh crore fly on train from Mumbai, whatever. And there are different other roads are in pipeline which can be done. So Japan calls for free open Indo-Pacific strategy. This news is important, that Japan diplomacy with India during Prime Minister Shinzo Abe latest, which is highlighted the countries intensifying the Indo-Pacific and Tokyo evolving foreign policy. And they will come here, they will talk about the South China Sea, about which I have told that this is very important, you must do the map work for it. So with this, I think that now most of the news have been covered from today. You require to do write down whatever the questions I am sending, because unless you will not write, I will not be in a position to appreciate the fact that your candidature for civil services main examination is very certain. Thank you.